think this is around about the time where they would tell you to listen to this track, bitch.
Right, but who are you? Just a nothing nigga with a strap. It don't take rocket science to shoot. You don't know shit. Yes. Welcome to AJK. Yes, I am on the pro. Yesterday was the man that I quote his saying all the time. I believe everything, mostly everything what he have said. I always quoted Malcolm X. Yesterday was his birthday, and I didn't want to say anything about Malcolm X yesterday because I want to talk about the cops yesterday. So today I'm dedicating. I usually do a random call, but I'm not doing any random calls today because this man deserved to be praised. And if it wasn't just for half of it, a lot of people, they worship Martin Luther King Jr. But on my hand, I believe everything what Malcolm X says. So I have this in between, like the rebel of Martin Luther King and Malcolm X. I'm not going to do violence towards anyone. That's why I always talk about the rebirth and the new trend. I am going to use their laws against them. So I'm like a little mixture between Malcolm X and Martin Luther King. But yesterday was his birthday. If he was alive today, he would have been 91 years old. And a lot of people really don't think about him that much. They think about Martin Luther King a lot, but they fail to realize when Martin Luther King was alive and he was going against all the white supremacists and everything, that he was talking to President Johnson, and somehow Martin Luther King and Malcolm X came together, and Malcolm X told Martin Luther King, listen, let them think that you and I are together so we can start a resolution. A lot of people don't read about them two coming together. So when they saw Martin Luther King and Malcolm X coming together, and I think they brought it out in the movie when they was talking about Martin Luther King, when they came together and they collaborated, and they started thinking that Martin Luther King and Malcolm X was going to start something, and they actually, it just... they saw Malcolm X as the bad guy, and they're like, oh, let me get with Martin Luther King, and let's talk about it and get this situation together. You know, we don't want them two collaborating together. So, yeah, it's awesome. Read about it. I always tell people, you know, most Caucasians will hide anything. They're going to hide it in a book. So I try to tell my people all the time, and whoever been listening to me, they would know that I always try to tell them, you know, go and read a book. And I have put books out there so they can read it and understand what is actually going on. Okay, so Malcolm X, my man, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. And that is my biggest word of, I believe, what he have always said. You know, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. He also put out, and a lot of people don't pay attention, but he's telling the truth. Like he said, if a black man is standing up and starting to go against a white man will pull a black man out of the audience and turn around and use that black man to go against that other black man. A lot of people don't pay attention to that. And he's telling the truth because, for instance, fine example, 2015, 2016, when you start seeing Ben Carson. Oh, my God, you never thought Ben Carson would come out. But Ben Carson said this when he was running for president. He said he's more blacker than Obama. See? Talking, going against someone. Why would you go against your own people? I mean, I never could understand that. But it makes sense when if you read Malcolm X. It makes sense. And it's 2016, and Malcolm X was talking all the way in the 60s. Talking about this all the way in the 60s. And it's 2016, this is still going on. They're not lynching, but they are killing. They're still killing. That's why I wanted to dedicate this day to Malcolm X, because everything that he said in the 60s, it is still going on. And people may say, no, we made a whole lot of progress. Tell me what progress have we made? We can vote, but now they're trying to go backwards and trying to stop people from voting. They're taking away anybody who did any criminal act. You cannot vote. And they're trying to block that. And other, everybody is trying to bring that forth. Like, if you did your time, you should be able to vote. I think so. Now, like, if you do certain crimes, I have a problem with that. Like, child molestation, raping. I don't think they should vote, because you never know what you may have someone who's a pedophile or a rapist running for office. And I wouldn't want that. And they may know that. So that, yeah, I think they should not vote. But other people who serve their time, I think that they should be able to vote. So how far have we gotten? We haven't got anything, because I know that a lot of young people, as myself, but I speak out. A lot of young people don't even think about how our ancestors actually went through a lot. They went through a lot. These white people, when they wanted to vote, they would ask them to quote different things that half of these white people didn't even know. They didn't even know half of the stuff that they was asking our ancestor quote. Or they would beat them up. Or they would torture them. They would hang them. They would, if just for voting. And most millennials, they act like, oh, I'm just all about the dollars. It's okay to be about the dollars, because I'm all about my coins too. But why are you not voting? And when things start happening in America, then you start questioning, why this happened? Why? Because you did not vote. You did not vote. And I always talk about voting. Don't just vote on when the presidential election come. You got to vote for general elections, because this is bringing in the Senate and the Congress. They come up for vote, and they want you to vote for them. They want to stay in it. We need to get these older people out of here. Mainly, they're old, white, and rich. That's who made the Constitution, old, white, and rich. It benefits them. It did not benefit us. Hell, they still have us as 3/5 of a person in the Constitution. So the best thing for us to do is get out there, go and vote, not just for the president, but also for Congress and the Senate. And that could get the people out of here. Okay? So now that we're going to talk about Malcolm X, I'm going to show you videos of the reaction of the death in 1965, mostly of white folks. And I'm comment on these, because I watched this video, and it's amazing what they were saying. I'm going to stop and I'm gonna try to stop in, or I'll just let it go on. But I just want you to see the reaction of the, and I'm on Periscope, so people just pay attention. I'm on Periscope. If you listening to me on speaker.com, you can go on Periscope. The you can look me up, The Rebirth and the New Trend, and you will see me. But I do want to play this video, the reaction of the Caucasians when Malcolm X got killed. This is what they had to say.
How do you feel about the killing of Malcolm X?
Well, I was quite shocked about it. I don't think it's quite the American way to go about things like this, by killing people. I think it could be settled else, otherwise.
What do you think this might lead to among Negro factions?
Well, I think they're going to have some trouble up in Harlem and throughout the United States. I think there's going to be a lot of propaganda, both here in the United States and out in the other countries.
What did you think of his philosophy?
Well, I didn't agree with it, but that still, it's his way, it's the American way. He can say what he wants.
Thank you. How do you feel about Malcolm's?
Now, she says she didn't agree with it. Why? He was speaking out and telling people that that it is wrong. It is wrong. They just didn't agree with him because they would say that he did violence. Well, if you do violence towards people, you wouldn't expect some violence to come back to you. You guys, most Caucasians have been violent. They are volatile people. And I tell this all the time. Most, not all, Caucasians are volatile people. So don't sit up there and say that you don't agree with his way. He got it from you. He just speaking out now. And like he said, the hens come to rest. You know what I'm saying? So don't sit up there. And I guarantee she really never have, because I'm going to show you another one. They didn't agree with his philosophy as well, but never, ever heard of his speech. So let's go on with this other Caucasian.
Killing. I feel that it will touch off a war here in New York City between the black Muslims and Elijah Muhammad.
Do you have any other feelings on it?
I feel that it will hurt the Negro cause.
In what way?
With this bloodshed being spilled now, especially when the Negroes need more help, more understanding from the white people, and the war that may take place.
That, and you see what I was trying to tell you guys when he said the Negro need more understanding from the white people. We don't need you to understand us. You already know us. That's how it is in 2016, and it's still going. Stop trying to fit in their culture, because did you hear this? And this is in 1965, and they still have the same idea and the same mentality that we want to fit in. Stop fitting in. Go ahead.
I feel certain that it will hurt the Negro cause.
Well, what did you think of Malcolm's philosophy, personally?
Well, I didn't agree with his philosophy, although I thought a lot of his character. I thought he was a very brilliant man. I happened to have the opportunity to listen to him one night on an all-night radio show, and what he said, I believe that he believed, you see. So he was fighting for his belief, which is...
what you respect that?
Yes, very much.
Thank you.
Okay, now,
how do you feel about the killing of...
I'm going to stop right there. Now, two people already said... Now, did you hear what they say? Two people already said that it's going to start a war between the Muslim, the woman said it, in it, or it's going to start problems in Harlem. Why? That is what they want us to do. Go against each other so they can keep this shit going on. People, don't believe the hype. Don't believe the hype. They want this, and they still doing this. They still using these tactics. I talked about it the other day about their tactics. They want us to fight amongst each other. That's why the Willie Lynch complex is still living. He said He thought it was just going to last about 500 or 600 years. No, it's still living. We still going against each other. So this young man right here, I'm going to play him. And the contradiction of his words really kills me.
I was deeply shocked. I didn't believe that things like that still went on in America. Another assassination like Kennedy's.
You consider it another assassination like Kennedy's to be equal?
Not exactly equal.
Not exactly equal.
You just
Why?
Didn't think things like this could happen in this country.
Because Kennedy was Caucasian.
What do you think this might possibly lead to?
Well, I believe there's a good chance of a future bloodletting like this one between the two factions of black Muslims. Between Malcolm X's and the other ones.
You see that?
What did you think of his philosophy?
He said, fight against
I really don't know. I didn't understand that much of it.
Did you ever hear him speak?
No, I did not.
Ha! Now, yeah, right there, I want to stop right there. How can he make an opinion about Malcolm X? He said that he disagreed with it and he doesn't agree with it. But then the reporter asked him, have you ever listened to it? No, I never have listened to it. How the hell can you say that you disagree with it and you never listen to it? That's why he didn't see Kennedy's death equal to Malcolm X's death.
Killing. Just the fact that he was shot down in broad daylight in a theater like he was, just that, it was shocking.
Now, he's saying he couldn't believe this would actually happen because of it's an American way. All three of these people was interviewed. All three of them was interviewed, and they saying they can't believe it's American way. It shouldn't happen like this. Get the hell out of here. It's still going on. And that was in 1965 of the interview when Malcolm X got killed. And they're sitting up there saying, well, it's the American way. I can't believe that somebody will gun someone down in the middle of the what? In what you're trying to insinuate. And that's why all three of them said it's going to be problems in Harlem or it's going to be problems against the Muslims. This is how they was thinking back then. Guess what, people? That's how they think now. Anything happen in the African-American community, they think it's going to be a problem. They think we're going to start fighting, wars, a riot. They think all that. Fine example. They wasn't surprised when Ferguson bucked off and started doing all that stuff. They wasn't surprised. That's what they want. They spread propaganda. They want you. They want you to fight against each other. They want you to tear the building down. Every time you turn around and tear those buildings down in your own neighborhood, they're going to build it right back in your neighborhood. And the chips may cost $1.50. They're going to charge you $2.69 because they're going to make that money up and then some. That was in 1965, people. 1965. This is 2016. 2016, people. You have to understand that this We came far, but we haven't came far. This stuff is still going on. They're still spreading propaganda. They're still doing. They're not hanging anymore, but they're shooting. I talk about cops every day. Show videos every day on here. You can't see the video. If you want to see the videos, what I show, you can go on Periscope. I'm on myspeaker.com. So people, don't believe the hype that everything is different. It's not different. They're not using a chain, or they're not using a rope or anything like that. They're using guns. And for slavery, they're using the jails. They're using the prisons. They're using these things to put you right back in slavery. They make you become a slave again. And you don't even realize. You think you're just getting locked up. Guess what? You're making things for certain people. That's why they invest in, they always investing in prisons. It's more prisons out here than hospitals. Why is that so? Wake up. So what I say, I'm educating you guys. Wake up. Smell the coffee. And what I say, it may look like coffee, but it don't smell like coffee. Let's go on and let's get Malcolm X, my man, on here about, and you know what I'm going to talk about, because I talk about it all the time, the Bible, the religion. People always bringing that up. But guess what?
Salaam alaikum.
Beloved brothers and sisters and friends of our radio audience, welcome to our weekly broadcast, Mr. Muhammad Speaks. This is the only weekly radio program in America that teaches the Muslim religion, the age-old religion, the religion of our forefathers. And these weekly broadcasts are designed specifically to bring spiritual enlightenment to our people, the so-called Negroes of America. This is Minister Malcolm X of New York City, substituting for the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, and speaking this week from Muhammad's Mosque number 15, which is located at 444 and a half Edgewood Avenue here in Atlanta, Georgia. Atlanta, Georgia, the gateway to the Deep South. And we are happy to be here this week with Mr. Muhammad's faithful, hard-working Atlanta representative, Minister Maya, who is doing a wonderful work, not only here in Atlanta, but throughout the Deep South. And our people here in the South are ready for a change. They want a religion that will give them a salvation, which includes freedom, justice, and equality here in this life and right here on this earth. Realizing that the Christian church has failed them, they are turning back toward the religion of Islam, the religion of our forefathers, the religion of the East. While we were members of the Christian church, we were rejected by the segregated churches of our slave master. In fact, we even failed to find unity and brotherhood in the churches among our own kind, among our fellow ex-slaves who call themselves Christians. When we were in the Christian church, no one wanted us, and we didn't even want ourselves. We were greatly divided. We rejected friendship and brotherhood among ourselves. We rejected friendship and brotherhood among our own kind. But as Muslims, under the divine leadership of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, our religion is Islam, the religion of the East, the religion of Africa, the religion of our own people back home today. And the Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that this was also the religion of our forefathers before they were brought here 400 years ago to this land of bondage, in chains, to be made slaves by our slave masters whose religion was Christianity. But most important of all, Islam is God's religion. Islam is the religion of all the prophets. Islam was the religion of Noah, the religion of Lot, the religion of Moses, and the Honorable Elijah Muhammad teaches us that Islam was the religion even of Jesus. As ex-slaves here in the land of our bondage, even though we become baptized,
I just want to get on that and talk about what he said, that they used, the slave masters used religion against us. They use it, and I've been saying that for the longest since I've been on here. They use the religion so they can keep us under control. Under control. And I want to go on to another another interview with Malcolm X live. That wasn't live. That just shows his picture. But this one will be live. It was in 1963, three years before his death. And he was... What did I click on? But he was talking about the history of Africa. Okay, hold on. Now my... is acting up now. But, I want to get this on here. The True Black History. And I want you guys to see when he was making a transition away from Islam.
And I have never seen you. And I have never seen the entire town. What things did you and I want to get together on? We've got to have some kind of thing. But as soon as we miss it, the only basis that we've got to get together on, they trick us by telling our leaders, you know, that anything that's all black will put segregation in the grass. Isn't that what they said? So the people who are black don't want to get together because they don't want segregation. See, the man is tricky, brothers and sisters. I mean, the man is tricky. He's a master of tricks. And if you don't realize how tricky he is, you're going to have to maneuver right on back into slavery. I shouldn't say back into slavery because we're not out of it yet. He's a trap that he creates. If you speak in an angry way about what has happened to our people, and what is happening to our people, what does he call it? Emotional. Pick up on that. Here's a man who's got a rope around his neck. Well, he's screaming, you know. If the crack that is putting the rope around his neck accuses him of being emotional.
You see, they accuse African Americans, once you find out about yourself and about your life, they accuse you of being so emotional. And he's telling the truth. He's telling the truth. I mean, he's telling the truth. But this is the return
from Malcolm X. Mecca. I think a lot of people confuse
this is the famous
by the new
speech.
Arabic name, El Hajj Malik El Shabazz.
This is always, I've always had the name on my passport, Malik El Shabazz, only I only used it in the Muslim world. Well, Hajj is a title that is given to any Muslim who makes the pilgrimage to Mecca during the official Hajj season.
Well, will you now use Shabazz and drop X?
I'll probably continue to use Malcolm X because, and I'll probably use it as long as the situation that produced it exists.
You don't feel that Shabazz takes the place of X?
My going to Mecca and going into the Muslim world, into the African world, and being recognized and accepted as a Muslim and as a brother may solve the problem for me personally. But I personally feel that my personal problem is never solved as long as the problem is not solved for all of our people in this country. So I remain Malcolm X as long as there is a need to protest and struggle and fight against the injustices that our people are involved in this country.
Now, this
we should
prepare
to go into the United Nations at this point and ask
we
the charges
got
be
this
brought
going
against
on
the United
today.
States
so
for
do you think we progress?
Negro.
Oh, yes.
Oh.
Oh, yes. Hey. I think you're right in my opinion. The audience will have to be quiet. As I pointed out when I was during my traveling, that nations look, African nations and Asian nations and Latin American nations look very hypocritical when they stand up in the United Nations condemning the racist practices of South Africa and that which is practiced by Portugal and Angola and saying nothing in the UN about the racist practices that are manifest every day against Negroes in this society.
Amen!
Even in South Africa,
amen.
Both Africans aren't faced
did
with
y'all hear that?
Aren't faced with
did y'all hear
dogs.
That?
I would be not a man if I was in a position to bring it in front of the United Nations
Hold up.
And didn't
let me,
do so,
let me
I wouldn't be a man.
See,
Malcolm,
see did you hear that? He said that America would go over, the UN would go over and try to solve problems overseas on racial problems, but they don't solve problems over here. Like, they're not, this is not a racist state over here. United States is more racial, it's more white supremacist, it's more racism over here than any other place. Any other place. Africa had the first African-American president before United States. And once they had a African-American president here in the United States, they start disrespecting him. They didn't disrespect Mandela. Not at all. But America tends to try to correct racism over to another country than over here, what they have so much a problem at. You have some goals. Let's go on. This man was ahead of his time. This stuff is still going on in 2016, people. Still going on. Let's go ahead. Proceed.
And leave the charge in the United Nations?
Well, I find that to say you're going to lead something creates a lot of hostility, division, jealousy, and envy. I hope to work with any group of leaders or any group of organizations to do whatever is necessary to see that this problem is brought before the United Nations.
Have you had any commitment from any nations in Africa to support your
move? I would rather not say at this time. But one thing I found in my travels, all of them look upon us as their long-lost brother.
You realize the implication is that you have had such commitments when you say...
This is your interpretation of what I said. One thing that I found
always
in all of my travels
turn
was
something
that
around.
All of the Africans, not only the Africans, but the Asians and the Muslims, look upon us as their long-lost brothers. And America had actually tricked many of them into a hands-off policy by giving them the impression that she was honestly trying to do something to solve the problem. My argument over there was designed to prove that it is impossible for the United States government to solve the race problem. It's impossible.
Malcolm, on your trip abroad, you said you sensed a feeling of great brotherhood and that conceivably you would be working toward integration in this country now. At least this is what you're reported to have said. Do you have any comment on it?
I don't think that I ever mentioned anything about working toward integration. They haven't even got integration right here in New York City. You have worse integration problems in the North than they have in the South. So if it doesn't work, if you can't bring about integration in New York City as international, cosmopolitan, up-to-date as it's supposed to be, you will never get integration anywhere else in the country.
Hello. Now, let's stop there. Let me stop there. Now, who talks about integration all the time? Donald Trump, talking about sending somebody back to their own country. Hell, this is not your country either. But this was in 1960, and this shit is still going on today. Come on now. People, wake up. Wake up. They're still doing the same identical thing. It's nothing new. Come to the light, and you will see it's still going on. Right now, they just can't put you in slave. They only put you in slaves when you get behind those jails or those prisons, and then you become a slave again. Hell, you need to look up FEMA. If FEMA decide to put you as a slave, they can. If anything, they can make a martial law. They can do all kinds of stuff. Start reading, people. I'm telling you, start reading. Let's go back.
Civil rights organizations.
Certainly. Certainly. We will work with any groups, organizations, or leaders in any way, as long as it's genuinely designed to get results.
Does your new beard have any religious significance?
No, not particularly, but I do think that you'll find black people in America, as they strive to throw off the shackles of mental colonialism, will also probably reflect an effort to throw off the shackles of cultural colonialism. and they may begin to reflect desires of their own, with standards of their own.
Malcolm.
Okay, do y'all know what he's saying?
Remarks was
when it says cultural
black people to
colonialism,
get rifles and form rifle clubs.
The same thing
back.
What they went through with the British
for self-defense.
I know
British try to force their own belief on
I think
them,
that
and they fought
them
in 1776. So please, they fought for their independence, but they didn't want us to have our independence. Isn't that something? Keep going.
The victim of the same kind of brutality that black people in this country face, and they saw that the government was either unwilling or unable to protect them, that the intelligence on the part of the whites would make them get some rifles and shotguns and protect themselves. Now, Negroes are developing some kind of intellectual maturity too, and they can see that having waited upon the government to protect them has been a wait that has been in vain. So any of them who live in areas where the government is not able to do its job, then we do have to get together and do a job of protecting ourselves.
Did you hear
no
that?
Leaders have fought
Did you hear that? Did you hear that, people? I talk about it all the time. As uniting together, come together. He said it in 1962. He said that. I didn't. And I said all the time, let's come together. They're going to keep us down, and they're going to we're allowing them to keep us down. They don't want us to come together, people of color. They want us to stay down. They want us to stay down. Malcolm X was ahead of his time. Malcolm X, do you hear me, was ahead of his time. This shit is still going on today. Have we made progress? If you want to believe that hype and think that we made progress, then so be it. Feel sorry for you. We haven't. They still the same way. Now they're put in, like, Ku Klux Klansmen now, most of them are just putting their sheet over their head, and you don't know who are with the Ku Klux Klan and who's not. So don't believe the hype and think that everything is solved. I had to play this today to let people know that this stuff is still going on. Propaganda is still going on. They're lying about us. They're seeing that we're thugs, whores, pimps, and everything. And we don't make it easy because these rappers out here continue to rap about stuff and say that they're pimps and call the woman a bitch and have no respect for her. So they're going to focus on the negativity over there, but it's positive over here that it's almost like 75%. Of us doing something positive and 25% of them not. But they will focus negative because they always want to make us look bad. They always want to make it seem like we're dumb. Mostly, hell, everything in America is made, invented by Africans or African Americans. Are done first. I want you guys, I want you to picture this. I know no one never figured this out. And I know a lot of African American men would continue to say that they have a hard time, but they never rate themselves on how I'm gonna show you. And I want you guys to think about this. It's a class. The first person who is more important in the United States is a Caucasian male. I want you to listen to me. A Caucasian male. The second one is a Caucasian female in that class. The third class, are you listening to me? That is being pictured here. The third class is the African American male. Third class. The last one on this class is an African American female. I bet you nobody never thought about that. That's why nobody, if an African American male kill an African American female, he might get 3 years, if that much. If an African American male kill a Caucasian male or a female, he might get life or death penalty. I want you to think about that. Get up, my people. You unite. Let's unite together. Malcolm X preached this all the way in the 60s until his death, his assassination. We need to do the same thing. We need to unite. We need to come together. We need to learn how to work together, love together. Do not believe these lies that's going on. You know what's so sad? That, and I can admit this, living in the America, that I'm not like this anymore, just living in America, they have preached on, that's why I stopped watching news, preach in the news that you have to be afraid of an African-American male because he's going to jump you, he's going to rob you, he's going to do all this to you. Well, I got an attitude growing up, ooh, I'm so afraid of this African-American man. That's why they made Stand Your Ground. I always talk about Stand Your Ground all the time. Every time I used to be afraid of they're going to jump me or they're going to beat my butt or something like that. Now, I embrace my brothers. Because I don't listen to that propaganda that they preach on Fox News, all these CNN, all these other places that they preach. I read now. I look at documentaries. I get on. I may look at some television, but I never pay attention to the media. I try not to listen to the media. Now, when I would research, and I would see certain things like what I broadcast on here. And you'll hear it, that I may broadcast that cops have beat this person of color or something like that. And I'll research it before I broadcast it. But as really watching the news, sitting down and listening to all they bull crap, because they'll get someone the most dirtiest, the most unintelligent person on there of color and just say something stupid. They don't want to interview someone who's intelligent and care of themselves. For example, when we was out marching in the Martin Luther King parade, Martin Luther King Jr. parade, when his birthday occurred last year, he was marching. Somehow, I never get interviewed. I say I never get interviewed, but they will go on the side of me. They interview someone on the side of me. They was out there marching, but they was like, yeah, I'm out here, I'm a represent. They did. That's what they like, people. You never see them put anyone intelligent on there. If they do, they're going to put somebody who accused of fraud, that they do fraud all the time. Now, I don't condone it. I'm not with that fraud crap. But they always get, they'll interview somebody intelligent who did fraud, believe it or not. So, at the end of the day, people, don't believe the crap that they're putting out. Start reading. I just want to play one more speech of Malcolm X, and this was 1 week before his assassination. 1 week.
Brothers on the African continent. So the first step that has been taken, brothers and sisters, since Garvey died, to actually establish contact between the 22 million the 22 million black Americans with our brothers and sisters back home was done by two organizations. And you know we've got to unite with them because there are 700 million Muslims. And we sure need to stop being the minority and become part of the majority.
Did you hear that? Now, I want y'all, I want to talk about this situation before I leave. I want to talk about this. He said, you heard what he said. The minority, instead of being the majority, you be the minority. We be the majority, I'm sorry. And then instead of being the minority. I want to talk about the Muslim. To this day, and this is what happened. They was going against Muslims in 1960. And you see how they talk about Muslims now? See how Trump bring the hatreds out? Trump didn't put that hatred in them. They had the hatred in them for years. They just finally have the nerve to bring their asses out now. They hate Muslims. Why? Because we don't want to follow, most of them don't want to follow the Christians' belief. That they should have the right to believe whoever they want to believe in. The first thing you want to say, I don't want to talk to no Muslim. They don't believe in them. That is not the person. That's a religion, just like Baptists and stuff like that. I swear, people, just wake up. I just don't understand. Wake up and it just wake up. Have we came a long way? No, we haven't. We're still in the same thing. We are still here doing the same thing. We're still. They are still doing the same thing. But they're not lynching. They're not lynching. They are not lynching anymore. They're killing, and killing by shooting, and lying about it. They gonna always lie about it. White supremacists is always gonna lie. I want us to wake up and understand that Malcolm X been preaching this for the longest. Martin Luther King has been preaching this for the longest. Or we need to stop sitting on our asses and thinking everything has changed. You're crazy and insane. People, you have a great day. And I just want to leave you with this beautiful song. Rest in peace, Malcolm X. Thank you.